good morning, afternoon, evening.
Probably wondering what we're doing sitting inside a shopping centre. But to explain, we're sitting in Central, which means we're in Croydon. Why are we in Croydon?
Well, today is round two of racing the Superloop.
Going to be racing from here up to Heathrow. So that should be fun.
Yeah, so the SL7 has decided to take up the challenge where the SL8 failed last time.
Major fail, if you ask me, but still. But special shout out before we move on, considering that we've got Valentine's Day coming up, would have already happened. Happy Valentine's Day to all those in love, and I've got a little Valentine's party room for you.
Okay.
Roses are red, violets are blue. Prepare for a woo when I beat you.
Oh dear. And you can almost imagine that when Danny's video comes out, there's probably going to be a whole lot more of that. So I feel sorry for all of you.
But anyway, lay down the rules.
The rules, so.
Yep. No overground.
No overground.
No national rail.
No national rail.
And if you do get on any trains, you have to get on at the exact point where you get onto the platform. Same as always.
So basically the same rules as last time.
Yeah, but throwing a little span in the works as well, found out there's engineering work on the trams.
Yes, that that did crop up when I was looking at the route. So that's going to be fun. The other thing that cropped up on the route that I was originally planning to take was also the Piccadilly line happens to be closed this week between Acton and Heathrow.
What am I going to say about that one is good luck.
Yeah, so we are looking at possibly quite an epic win for the Superbowl.
Well, that's what we find out, because as you know, as everyone here will know, anything's possible on the roads.
Yep.
Nothing on that, no?
Well,
let's crack on.
Let's crack on and get going.
And may the best man win, which I know I will.
Yeah. Good luck. Okay, so.
Let's get ready to rumble.
It's 11 o'clock on the dot.
Yeah, let's see how long it takes, and I'll see you at Heathrow.
See you then.
Have fun.
Well, this is a good start, isn't it?
Yeah. This is great for that. There you go,
tram replacement.
First one I've seen all. Oh, see, it's been up here.
Yep.
Shout out to Reeve for running the tram replacement service.
Someone's got to.
Can't forget where we're shouting them out, because it's my own, because it's the company I work for.
I suppose it also helps that they're running it, because I think they're the ones that run the trams anyway.
Yeah, plus as well, they've got the pretty much got a monopoly in the area in terms of buses. Between them and go ahead, I think.
Yeah, it's very much a go ahead and a Arriva area.
Yeah, so where you? So, in fact, no, I'm not going to ask it because I don't want to know what your first step is. I think I already know, but I'm not going to call it out. It'll be a surprise for everyone else, including myself as well.
Yeah, well, it'll be a surprise for when it actually does come out on the video.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, I'm going over to that side. Crossing over.
Yeah, well, I'm going over this side.
Alright, see you later.
See you later. Right, so while Danny's wandering off to find where he's picking up his bus from, considering he's actually taken the wrong bus, I'm now heading for Reeves Corner. Now, because there's no trams on this section of the route today, I now have to take a bit of a walk. Luckily I've already planned this part out, so I have got a good chance of getting to where I need to go.
So
So once I get to the tram stop, we will start going through which route we're taking. So I will catch up with you then. Okay, so this is my first tram, or B tram. So it's starting from Green's Corner, where I am at the moment. So this will take me down to Croydon. From here, when we eventually get going, we'll be heading to Wimbledon, jumping on the 490 to Richmond, or is it the 493? Actually, it's the 493. So, yeah, so the 493 to Richmond, 490 to Hatton Cross, and then whatever bus goes from there to Heathrow Central. So, I'll be back to you when this tram starts moving. And here we go. Wrong road in from Reeves Corner. Isn't that unusual? Bit of movement. Thank you.
This tram is for Wimbledon. The next stop will be Ampere Way. At Valley Park retail stores and entertainment complex. for Wimbledon. The next stop will be Mitcham.
For buses to Rose Hill, Sutton, Belmont, and Tooting.
Terminate. That would be my first change.
Change there for National Rail Services. London Underground District Line and bus connections to Putney, Kingston, Tooting and Streatham.
Find this bus stop. Move this up there. Oh, it's Electric Bus Central. Always be riding the Enviro 200s. Given that I've planned this journey out, I hadn't actually considered where my bus stops were. So I'm hopeful. Not that one. This is where I'm going to have my slow connection. Okay, I remember now. I've crossed over the road when I didn't need to. And it's time to cross back. It helps if I've come out the right entrance. Oh, that's good. I just missed the bus. How long do I have to wait for that now? Oh. Let's hope that one was running late. There's the bus stop. Right, what's the time? 11:42. Okay, so it's taking me 42 minutes to get here. And
yeah, well, when, again, when I set it up, I assumed that wasn't the case.
4:93. Every 10 to 14 minutes. So I've probably got about a 9 to 13 minute wait. Excellent. With about another 35 minute journey. I'll come back to you.
New logo?
Anyway, I'll come back to you when the bus is arriving. Yeah. Right. Bus is coming. Richmond, we have fun. I started my slow journey. Oh, what a good start.
Older people are
bad at shooting.
Goodbye, Wimbledon.
Yeah. Station.
So I finally got off the bus. So time now is 1 o'clock. It's taken 2 hours and I've only got to Richmond and I've still got another bus to get. Well, actually 2 buses to get. So that goes against all the things I know about go ahead of normally being fast drivers. That was so damn slow. A journey that is peak time. Yeah. Peak times are supposed to be 36 minutes to where I just got off. That took over an hour. Not less. So my next journey is on a 490. And the stop just round here. Thank you. Comes as this is taking so long, and there's slight change of plan and slight change of route. It was going to be the 490 all the way to Cat the Cross, but that's not likely. That's going to take over an hour, and well, I haven't got over an hour of time, so it's now going to be 490. I have to do a bit of checking on Google, so 490 to Hounslow and Hanworth Road, and then changing for a 285. And it was the 285 that I got on. I recorded fairly recently, so that will be released soon, the full route visuals for that route. So they are coming up. So yeah. Once this 490 turns up, which should hopefully be in the next few minutes, with any luck, we can get moving again. So this is this route is run by what was a Melio, it's now Transport UK London. A recent change at the beginning of the month with their new company name. So yeah. Hopefully, well, more than likely, that Danny has actually beaten me. So yeah, Danny's beaten me. He can't have not beaten me today. This is a terrible journey. If I'd realised beforehand, I might have gone via the original route I had planned, was to go on the district line up to old school and then Piccadilly line here to Acton Town. Then I could have got the Piccadilly line replacement, which would have been pretty cool to get. I still probably wouldn't have beaten him anyway. Still a 5 minute wait. It's a bit ridiculous. There's no way Danny can lose to me now. There's no way I can win. Where's Doctor Who and his TARDIS when you need him?
Heathrow Airport, Terminal 5.
Thank you.
90 to Heathrow Airport, Terminal 5. Assembly hall. Heathrow Airport, Terminal 5.
So let's summarise my journey so far today. I've had to wait an age for buses. I've had to sit on buses for an age. I've had waits for buses. Well, I've already said that, waits for buses. But I've had to walk at the beginning to then get on the tram to Wimbledon at Leeds Corner. That wasn't too bad. But the journey from Wimbledon to Richmond took forever. So a 29-minute journey, or 36-minute journey rather, it should have taken. It ended up taking over an hour. Ah, here we go. Always count on a Superloop. It's the judo version.
Central.
How did I guess? How did I know you were going to be absolutely flooring me?
About 20?
Yeah, that sounds about right.
Crazy.
Well, well, you notice what bus I came off of? If you can't beat them, join them.
that was...
Yeah, you had a good journey.
I was lucky.
Yeah.
Literally 3 minutes. Literally 3 or 4 minutes away for the SL7.
Yeah.
Only had a couple of pockets of traffic. One set of temporary lights, no driver change. So of course, once we hit these little gauges, that was it, garbage, it's water now.
Yeah. So yeah. do I even need to go through what I went through?
Is it that bad?
It was that bad. It was the walk from West Croydon to Rees Corner.
Yeah.
No problem at all. Took me about 3 or 4 minutes.
Okay.
Just missed the tram when I got there.
Nah.
So, fine. Only waited about... Okay. Only waited about 5 minutes for the next one. So that was fine. Got to Wimbledon, no issues. Came out the wrong entrance at Wimbledon.
Oh no.
Crossed over the road when I didn't need to cross over the road. Crossed back over the road. Missed the bus.
Nah.
8 minutes later, get the next bus. Driver changed straight away.
Oh, ouch.
And so the 493, run by Go Ahead, you think, yeah, okay, they've put their foot down. No. This guy put his foot down in reverse. Well, he might as well have done.
Never know.
He could not have been going more than about 15, 20 miles an hour the entire journey.
Jeez.
So the journey from Wimbledon to Richmond should have only taken, according to the timetable, 36 minutes.
I'm guessing it took more like...
Over an hour.
Yep, sounds about right. My journey to get to it took slightly longer than what he said on the thing, but...
But then there was traffic.
Yeah, yeah.
So of course, yeah, that only got me to Richmond.
And then you had the fun from there.
So yeah, so you probably got here about the same time I was arriving in Richmond.
Flipping heck.
And so yeah, I got off, walked around the corner, waited for the 490. And yeah, I was, I had a bit of about 14 minute wait for that. They run every 20.
Yeah.
So not long missed that. Might have caught it if the 493 had actually been going at a decent speed. So yeah, so that was that. That was slightly better. I thought, okay, let's see if I can do this, speed this journey up a bit. Because when I checked out that route before, it was supposed to take over an hour to get from Richmond to Hatton Cross. So I thought, okay, let's try and speed the journey up. See where I can change and get a bus in quicker.
Yeah.
I thought, right, okay, change at Hounslow or near Hounslow for the 285.
Yeah.
I checked up on the timetable. 26 minute wait.
Ow.
Before one gets back in here. So I then, when I looked at where the two buses going after it told me where to change, I then noticed that both of the buses go exactly the same way.
Yeah.
To get to Hatton Cross. So I thought, screw changing. The bus that I was going to get on was only minutes behind me anyway.
Yeah.
So I thought it was not worth it. And that was terminating early.
Okay.
So I thought, forget that. So got off at Hatton Cross and spotted some Piccadilly line replacements. Wish I'd actually gone on the tube. But then you still might have beaten me, because who knows how long they would have taken.
No, it's any.
So I, yeah.
So, yeah, at least you made it.
I made it eventually.
Yeah, I had enough time to have a chat with a mate of mine who's working customer information for the replacement buses up here.
Yeah, you've had a nice chill out time in Heathrow Airport.
It's contrast to last time.
Yeah.
Pretty contrast to last time.
Well, let's put it this way. I know the titles of the video say Superloop versus the tube.
Yeah.
This was Superloop versus the bus.
The Superloop still won.
And the Superloop still won. So hence the reason why I joined the Superloop.
So that makes it 1-1 now.
So it's 1-1. So yeah. Let's hope the tube has more success next time when it has its rematch.
Are we get on?
Because the tube will ask for a rematch.
Yeah.
What, like the Superloop is asking for a rematch between Uxbridge and White City.
Yeah, I think for that one, I'll
I'll be running the tube side of things.
Yep, you'll be running the tube side of things. And I'll be taking your job of sitting down and having a relaxing journey. None of this hurtling around like an absolute lunatic,
yeah.
Trying to work out which way to go and then failing miserably.
I think we need to sum up, really.
Yep. Yep, let's sum up. Let's go for a double shot.
Yep. I'm not going to do it on one. Do it on the other.
Okay, well, actually,
let's go
then. Let's.
Right. Hey, guys, we're at the E-Pro Central. And with about an hour and 20, maybe a bit more waiting, they can finally shut it off.
Yeah, I made it eventually. Blame engineering works.
So that makes it officially Superloop 1. Should we say TFL 1?
Yeah, I think it should now be Superloop versus TFL.
Yeah, I agree with that.
Yeah, there was just no tube involved today. There was not a tube train in sight. So we'll call it Superloop versus TFL in future.
Nice little one, so definitely be rematch.
Yeah.
When Rolls in first, and then I'll be suffering that time while Jamie gets to relax and enjoy a nice little journey.
And let's hope the tube wins. It needs to win after that one.
It does. Definitely going to be doing some more Superloop challenges, Superloop races. So until then, this is Danny, this is Jamie Hydropromise, signing out.
Don't forget to like and subscribe.
Bye.
Bye.